Hi guys, hope you are well. Just wanted to take this opportunity to come and chill out with you guys. I'm gonna do a small meditational session. We've been talking through some of the finer details of samurai meditation. Just trying to get able so you can see me. And because it's been quite a stressful time for everyone, what I wanted to do was also give people the opportunity to maybe de-stress through these meditational techniques, but also through the massage that I'm qualified in. So I specialize in deep tissue massage, that's for the full body, but we also do face massage as well. So I just wanted to give a few tips and pointers to people to de-stress themselves, and I thought some of the breathing techniques, a little bit of meditation, and a self shiatsu face massage would go down a treat. So it's not the same as when someone else does it, but it does help de-stress. If you've got some stressful headaches or you've got some migraines, I've had a couple recently, it might just help you get through those migraines. So it's a meditational session. So you're joining here tonight. I've got some natural sounds in the background. I think it's a thunderstorm going, which is very not like the weather here. So sitting on my cushion, I'm in Shiatsu, which is the kneeling position. And we're going to start with the some trigger points on the face massage that will help you relax. So the breathing techniques that we've been using are into, as described this morning in the videos and some of the other meditation videos I put up, we're thinking big ball and little ball. So we're breathing into the big balloon, into the big ball here, through the nose first, really pumping up this area with everything we can now. So we're breathing in all the positive energy, breathing that nice and deep, and then the last little bit that we breathe in comes into the smaller ball into the chest cavity. Now when we breathe out, we're pushing on the big ball and we're exhaling all the negative energy out, decompressing the chest first and then decompressing the big ball. So it's a cycle of breathing in through the nose, big ball focus, and then lung focus, and then on the way out we're keeping the oxygen in our bellies, in the lower area of the diaphragm, and we're pushing out the chest first. And then so that's what we're doing on the breathing side of life. Meditation has to have a purpose, so I'm gonna now do some of the facial massage before I drop into the meditation with you. So just start by combing across two hands from across the middle of the forehead, and you can do this lying down as well. I'm doing it in seated because I'm going to go into meditation, but you can do it lying down. So just quite firmly but not too hard, just with the tips of your fingers, just bring that across, slide it across into the temple area. Again, the temples, gentle rotation. I find the middle fingers right into the middle of the temple, just nice and light. Sometimes I rotate very gently, like a pigeon or running on the spot, but just very circular motions, very light circular motions of both these fingers, and alternate them, using, and again, you can breathe at the same time. Okay, so we swiped across and fell down into these temple areas. That's the first one. And then either finger will do, one finger, I normally use this one, middle finger, the index finger. I put my thumbs back in my temples because it helps me grip where I need to be, especially when I'm lying down. And I'm just gonna start on the inside here, the above the eyebrow. I'm just gonna push in, and then a couple of centimeters apart, and work my way back out this way. I'm gonna start here, and I'm gonna push just above the eyebrow area, equally coming through all the way around the top of the eye. And then I'm gonna hook under with my thumbs. I'm coming into the center of the bridge here, just above the tear ducts, not pushing into the eye, but pushing up towards the brain, I suppose, if you wanna look at it like that, and coming under this ridge. And just very lightly, because it's quite sensitive, just applying pressure there. Just above the tear ducts, going into the brain, just very lightly. And then again, working my way back towards the temple. Okay, so that kind of smooth that back over. Now coming under here, now working our way around the eye region here. So again, just smoothing that through. I can use my two fingers. So again, come round the eye sockets. Now, moving down the face onto the cheekbone area. And now I'm using all the four fingers, not just two, but you can use two fingers and come across the cheekbone area. Or you can start to use implement. And all I'm doing is I'm lightly applying pressure. You can think about it like a bird crossing, walking on ice. So not too hard, but enough to get contact. And here, now, underneath the mastic here, if we want to, just underneath the cheekbone, we put all four fingers underneath the cheekbone, all here. Yeah, so underneath here, we can rotate the cheeks, relax the cheeks. And again, I use this tip tapping, and circular motion of the tip tap. Hard to do while I'm talking, but tip tap. And this will release the jaw. If you've got any sinus issues, it might help release the sinuses. You might feel that in here. So just loosen up those cheeks. Do it yourself. Loosen up those cheeks. Okay. Next one. Thumb in just below the nose, so follow the bridge of the nose all the way down to the bottom, get to the teeth line, shut your eyes and just push that again gently. It shouldn't hurt, so just push it. Make sure you're not digging your nail into your nose, but just push that into the upper region of the teeth that you can feel on the inside. You should feel that start to relax. Still keep the breathing. I know it's difficult because we're talking, but when you're doing this yourself, it'll be a lot more relaxing. And then that's released that off. And the same two fingers working out around the mouth, up the lips, but on, you can feel the teeth on the inside. Okay. Then we get to the chin area. We can grab the chin and just tug it a little bit down, so just grab, tug and pull. It sounds a bit bizarre, but just get the fingers underneath. So on the flappy bit of the chin, so not touching any of the bone, but just the skin area. Both fingers, grab around and just pull gently. Pull yourself home, but just pull that gently down. Okay, and then we can walk back, work our fingers from here, back up the jawline. In behind the jaw, run our fingers over that jawline, over the jawline on the side there. And again, just where we were before on the cheeks, I find that just relaxing that off over here and pulling the cheeks at the same time, so in a motion like this, here, so motion, I just relax the back of the jaw there. And the cheeks again. Cheeks a bit. Okay, so that's like a nice little face routine that you can do. Takes literally 2-3 minutes, but it really starts to relax your face. You realize how tense your cheeks are, you're holding a lot of tension there, so it's nice. Is really quick, really helps relax. If you look at the ear, actually, it looks a little bit like a baby in a fetal position. So if you start here, where if you imagine the eyes would be on this fetus, and you just with two fingers pinch around the top of the ear and all the way down again on yourself, halfway through you have to change that to the other way, but still pinching all the way until you get to the earlobe, and then just gently pull the earlobe, not too hard. So back up to the top, pinch all the way through, all the way around. So follow the baby spine around the top ridge and just gently pinching. Do it on both sides, don't let one side down. And then swap over, so that's the other round, get to the, and if you can do it and you've got coordination, nice and gentle, pull those earlobes down. You can do it both at the same time. And you can pinch until you feel it. It's not meant to be painful, but you should be able to feel. I don't use the fleshy bit, I use the side, almost the diagonal point of my fingers to actually get in to really feel that there's a pressure point, there's a point of what I'm doing. Okay, so that's a really nice head routine that you can do. Face and head is just to relax you off, should get rid of any headaches. Again, it will really help the sinuses in here and in here. So it will help decongest the face as well. You can tap along the cheekbone a little bit more vigorously. Just reminding that because of the rain. So this light tapping I use in, just as an effouage on my deep tissue massage, just to warm up the area, get the blood flowing. Little light taps all over the face. It works, it's really, really nice. It feels great even though you're doing it yourself. Okay, so then moving on to the meditational part. As I said before, all meditation needs a point. So you don't need to reveal the point of your own meditation to me, and I'm not gonna reveal mine, but if you've got a question or you wanna tune into something, then you start by internally focusing on that, the point of the meditation that you want to achieve. So if it's been a stressful week, or you're trying to make a business decision, or you're just trying to relax, so the point of the meditation would be to self-center, to be in more contact with self, to not stress, to not have the anxiety. I want to get rid of all of that, and I want to understand that right in the present where we are now is really amazing. That would be the point of my meditation now. So again, my right hand over my left hand. It's not gonna have to be 20, 30 minutes. I'm gonna use the circular technique that we just discussed right at the start. Go 3 really deep breaths and controlled, and then I'm gonna relax that cycle. And I'm gonna start to focus in on the rainstorm that I've got playing behind me, just to really focus into Mother Nature, if you want to call it that, or if you just to really get the energies there. As I'm breathing in, I'm always breathing in positive, and I'm exhaling the negative. Okay, so I'm just relaxing myself, just making sure that my shoulders now, so I'm aligning myself. I have to be aligned, it's really important. My hips, I'm in Cesar, for the people that just joined, I'm in Cesar position, which is the kneeling position, which the samurai use. You might want to use the lotus position, the half lotus, but it's important for energy and to keep the hips slightly raised. So that's why I'm like that. I also see people doing it directly on the floor, and it can be quite disturbing to the energy flows. So anyway, so didn't mean to get into that now, but just to make people aware of that, to try and get a pillow underneath their seat. My right toe is over my left toe again. My right hand is now over my left hand. So I'm just going to remember what I'm here for. Breathing deep into the belly, filling up the big ball a little bit deeper through the nose into the chest, and then focusing heavily, it's difficult to do this and talk at the same time, focus heavily on pushing out my stomach, because I want to keep that the diaphragm low, and then I'm exhaling through the mouth. People do use an R sound, a really low R sound. I use sometimes that, I don't even sometimes make that noise. It's more of a deflating balloon sound, if you want to call it that. So whatever sound works for you, there are different notes that you can hit, and there's different sayings that you can actually say. If you're struggling, really struggling to focus, and you're manic, then I've got a book of lines that just text me, and I can give you actual meditations to recite yourself mentally and in a low tone to allow you to progress into a relaxed state if you're really finding it hard to switch off and to focus. Other ways you can do it, you can put a candle in front of you and focus on the flame. You can listen, like I'm doing now, listening to a thunderstorm or waves hitting the beach. Either way, find your own rhythm. This is about you finding yourself and having that quiet time, which right now you need to create the space, and the space comes when here. In here we're completely free, and we're also trapped. So to be able to unravel the voices and to get to the bottom of things and to bottom that out and to recenter will give us this equivalent of a 10-mile run. If not more. Muhammad Ali used to use meditation once a week as a full training session, a 40-minute training session. So it should recharge you and give you an idea of how to focus. I will be putting this up on the YouTube channel, on Kokoro YouTube channel, so that you can rewind it and go over it as many times as you want, because the face massage and all the other things won't be mentioned now. Okay, so again, head aligned, shoulders aligned all the way through. Big deep breath into filling up the big balloon, then little balloon, and then holding, pushing out big balloon. So little balloon empties first, and then out. So we do three really big ones of these. The exhales can take up to 60 seconds. So I'm just going to use my hands to show you which ball I'm filling up. I wouldn't normally move my hands, I'd normally sit them here. And if I was in lotus, then I'd swap my legs over and I'd keep my hands here in front of me. So we're okay, so they're the three deep breaths. And from there, I would then settle in to not as deep breaths, but just to cycle it in a little bit. So it's not so exasperated, but still keeping the rhythm of breathing into the belly, into the chest, and then out the chest, out through the belly. I say the belly because this is what the samurai talk about, is these energy points. But really it's just controlling the way that this diaphragm stays full down here into our energy center. So I'm just nice and relaxed now, just going to focus on the rain in the background. Sometimes when I've got the flame alight, I focus on the candle, or even I shut my eyes and I light a scented candle, and I try and really focus in on those scents. As just for people that just joined, on the purpose of the meditation has to be, you don't think about it again. Once you've stated at the start of the meditation, you can switch it off. You don't need to go back into why you're meditating. But there will be, when you start to relax enough, there will be subconscious messages that you can focus on, that you'll get the answers to what you're focusing on. Either way, don't stress about it. It will just happen. And if it doesn't happen, just practice it again. The breathing is good for you. And you will feel more relaxed either way. Even if you don't necessarily understand the subconscious or what's happened, it's still well worth doing. I've done enough pretty much for today. Those three breaths have helped me really unwind, even though I've been talking the whole way through it. But I just want to do another 3 to 5 breaths just for myself now. Just to focus in on the rain behind, and just to relax. So you're welcome to stay with me again. So dropping back into this meditation, I now can hear some of the crickets that have come out on the computer there. So head nice and light, shoulders pinned back and just relaxed, right hand over left. And then I'm just going to have these 5 personal silent breathing circular cycled breathing now. So as we said, big balloon, little balloon, holding on to the big balloon, out from the little balloon, out from the big balloon, and we're going to repeat that cycle. Really let it all go, really feel it, really want, give yourself permission to relax, especially right now. We harbor so much inside of us. Our brains are working so hard all the time. Give yourself permission to take this time for yourself. You've only asked for 5 breaths. So breathe in the positive and start to exhale and really feel it. Feel your body dropping. Feel your body gaining that weight of relaxation. Your mind has to be relaxed. It's your biggest and most powerful muscle that you have. Give yourself permission to relax. Switch off all the noise. Now again, I make 2 distinct noises, and it's only for me, and it's only to help me personally. When I'm trying to exhale the top part of my lungs first, I find it difficult to make the R sound because I get confused in them both. Now I'm actually focusing on this breathing. So when I make the, first I have to make that sound, and that helps me deflate the chest. Because I'm still pushing out on my stomach. And then last but no means least, that's when I really, and what I like to do is I really relax, because I've been focusing on that, I really relax when I empty that big ball. I really let my whole body drop and I can feel it going. So I hope that's been useful. I know it's only been 10, 15 minutes. It doesn't need to be more than that. And obviously, the less I speak, the more we can tune in the next session together. But just practice that breathing technique. Do the face massage. It will really, really help. And stay safe and hopefully stay sane. And if you have any questions, if you want to do another meditation session, if you, on the massage side, if you've got any questions, if you're working in pairs and you want some FOH techniques for levator scapula, which is where we harness all of our stress, then yeah, send me a message, Instagram me, and we can give you some tips, hints, and or some a Zoom session, and I can try and help you there as well. So yeah, take care, God bless you, and we'll see you all again soon.